had 4 sessions of PRP for hair loss, and there are 2 sessions remaining, but no sign of stoppage until now. Is this normal? I'm 22 years old, facing dense hair loss problems, and underwent PRP for this. I had 4 sessions already, and 2 sessions are left. Still, my hairs are shedding, and there is no stoppage. Is there any chance that my hair will stop falling and regrow?
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question without any photos, but you state that you're 22 years old, you're losing hair, you have had 4 PRP sessions, you have 2 more remaining, and you're asking if this will stop your hair loss, and you're noticing continuous shedding. And so I understand why you're asking if there is going to be any benefit. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance on how I counsel my patients for hair loss in our practice. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon, fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a non-surgical solution for hair loss, which we developed using PRP as well as its combination with acellular matrix, vitamin D, and other things that is a particular protocol. So hair loss treatment is something we do every day in our practice. In fact, we have patients coming from all over the world specifically for hair regeneration treatment. So I'm going to give you a little bit of perspective on your situation and my concerns about the use of PRP. To begin with, at 22 and having hair loss where you have significant shedding continuously, it basically means you have early onset and you appear to be having rapid progression. Again, without a photo, I can't comment that much more. And chances are there's a family history of this type of hair loss. Now, the challenge with a younger person who has early onset of rapid progression is how effective can an intervention be when you might be reaching the end of growth cycles that will never come back? You know, we sometimes refer to it as a terminal growth cycle. Now, PRP or platelet-rich plasma does have some benefit for people with hair loss, but the benefit, in my experience, is limited. It's limited to the short-term growth of hair that is affected by the stimulatory effect of PRP. But in my experience, PRP does not stop progression, and the sustainability is reliant on constant injection. It can be every month, every 3 months, every 6 months. In some cases, people have done this every week. Hair regeneration, what we do for our patients, which does use PRP, evolved out of a process that we were first using to help hair transplant patients. What we wanted was hair grafts to heal better and therefore improve yield, as well as we wanted the donor area where the hair was harvested from to heal better. A side effect in a lot of people was that thinning hair became thicker. Now, that being said, what I did was I took the initiative to then try to develop a consistency of doing this for people with thinning hair, for both men and women. It took several years to develop, but now we have a process to the point where now we've created a company called TrichoStem Hair Regeneration. Basically, the intention is to try to bring our technology to help people with hair loss outside of our 2 offices in Manhattan and Long Island. Now, what's the difference? TrichoStem Hair Regeneration, or hair regeneration in our practice, allows people with male and female pattern hair loss to have 99% success, sustainable for 5 years, and this is defined by stopping progression, reactivation of hair that's not growing and that continues to grow without continuous reinjection, as well as the inducing of thinning hairs to shed and thicker hairs to grow in. And it often is seen as something that is too good to be true, and we understand that. And what I've done is basically implemented a very strict process of follow-up. We follow our patients every 3 months, and we see them for continuously, and with patients who may potentially benefit from what we call a booster injection, we'll re-inject them around 15 months with a different formulation. But we follow people every 3 months to 6 months for up to 3 years. And then we follow them annually to monitor them for any regression. 5 years of data of patients who come to us from all over the world has shown no regression of benefit. There are going to be occasional people that it does not work for. But as I said, 99% it does work for. So I think that in a situation like yours, when someone like you comes to us, we basically feel that, or I should say, I essentially feel that the earlier I treat someone, the better it is. Because the limit of our treatment is the inventory of hair follicles and the inventory of salvageable hair follicles. So the discussion you should have with your treating physician is the question that you're posting. Is this normal? Is it likely that you'll see an improvement? What we've been able to do is state clearly with hair regeneration that there's 99% odds of improvement, defined by the three things I mentioned, as well as with following up people so closely and observing them, we still have an opportunity to customize treatment for their specific needs. But this is definitely a different way to approach hair loss than what you're currently undergoing. The point is to understand that in my experience, PRP, which I use a lot in my practice as a cosmetic surgeon, as someone who does a lot of cosmetic dermatologic procedures. I use PRP for dark under eye circles. I use it for acne scars. I use it for fine lines and wrinkles, for sun damage. We love using PRP for a lot of reasons that are skin quality related. But for hair loss, we use it as part of a treatment process. So, with that understanding, this is an opportunity for you to learn more about other options that you may not have been aware of, such as hair regeneration, and ask your doctor about the realistic expectations with this current treatment plan and whether or not you may want to consider other alternatives, such as taking oral finasteride, as well as possibilities in the future for hair transplantation. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.